You're watching PEGRI TV, Rhode Island's public access channel.
Welcome everybody to Figures R Us, your official wrestling collector show and Q&A show from the Official Wrestling Museum. We are your hosts. I am Angel.
And I am Blazing Iconette Missy.
And thank you guys for tuning in. We are glad for everybody and thankful for everybody that's sending your questions in to us. We're going to get to them later on in the program. Still time to send in more questions for following week, so make sure you guys do that. If you guys missed Off the Ropes this week, you shouldn't. We talked about the great Mick Foley. Next week we'll talk about Taker. Can't go wrong with that. Before we go any further, we got to say hats off to Kane. You're the new mayor, man.
Yeah, congrats,
and you know what?
Dude.
I think you're going to be somebody that can go someplace.
Oh,
don't
yeah,
be like
definitely.
Our president, because he's a... But anywho.
Next president.
Right? You know what? He worked really hard, though. He was out campaigning.
Really
did. He did what he needed to do.
Not to
hats
mention
off.
The
and
fact,
he's a great
still
guy.
Wrestling at the same time as campaigning. Like,
yep.
That's crazy.
And he's a great, great guy.
Yeah.
We didn't get to do our SummerSlam predictions because we were so into Mick Foley on our show this week. So we're going to kick off today with our predictions of what we think are going to happen this coming Sunday for SummerSlam. Now,
yep.
For the Cruiserweight title, there's...
Cedric Alexander.
Yep.
Again. Versus Drew Gulak.
Who do you think is taking it?
I say Gulak.
I think it's going to be Gulak's time. They build him up a lot. The guy deserves it. He's a phenomenal worker. He's even from around
he's
here.
He's definitely doing good.
Oh, yeah. I know who you're going to go with here because odds on favors for
there's
you for the U.S. title.
One.
Shinsuke Nakamura, Jeff Hardy, who you take?
I have to go with my ultimate favorite, okay? Because I just absolutely love him. But to tell you the truth, I really think they're giving it to Nakamura.
I'm going to agree with you with that as well, too. I think something with Orton is going to be played into it. If Jeff wins, Orton might help Jeff win it. I'm
yeah.
not sure. I think Nakamura is still going to take it. Keeping the title on Jeff Hardy, they ain't going to do nothing for him. Jeff is Jeff. He don't need a title.
Jeff
belt.
Will always be Jeff. Like he really doesn't need a title for anything.
SmackDown Women's Championships on the line in a three-way dance.
Yeah.
Kamala, Charlotte Flair, Becky Lynch. Who's taking it?
I say Lynch.
I want to go with Lynch as well, too. There's a slight chance that Kamala could come out ahead to do the feud with Becky and Charlotte because I don't think they want them to really get that tea friendship shown
right.
on the screen because they're doing the same thing with Bayley and Sasha on Raw,
right.
and they're coming out with the women's tag title soon. But I really hope they don't do a feud line with them. I don't think it will get over. I'm going to go with Lynch as well, too. I think you're
okay.
reading my brain over here. Kevin Owens against Braun Strowman, and if Owens wins by DQ, pin, submission, count on any means necessary, he becomes the new Money in the Bank champion. Who's taking it?
Strowman.
I think they're going to go with Strowman as well, too. Even though Strowman's on a losing streak, I think that will get it over. Owens will be a great Money in the Bank champion, but I just think they did too much messing up last year with the women's title. Women's Money in the Bank briefcase with Ellsworth actually becoming the very first one, if you really think about it.
Yeah.
Shout out to you, Ellsworth. We'll rehire you. We'll get that hashtag going for you.
Yeah, right.
But I think it's going to go with them. Now, they just recently put on, it's going to be Finn Balor against Baron Corbin. Who do you think is taking it?
I have to go with my ultimate Finn.
Yeah.
Because he's just my fave.
I'm going to flip it on this one. I think Corbin's going to take it. And I think the reason they're going to give it to Corbin is he's got that new role.
Mm-hmm.
He's powerful. And I think they need to give him that win in order to keep him non-wrestling role powerful on TV.
Right.
So I think it's going to be Corbin on this one. Now, the SmackDown Tag Team Championships are going to be on the line. The Bludgeon Brothers are either going to take on Usos or The Bar. Now, we're recording this right now, so we're not exactly sure who it is at this moment. If it's the Usos against the Bludgeon, who do you think is going to win?
I definitely say the Bludgeon Brothers.
If they're against the Bar?
I still say the Bludgeon Brothers.
I think it's going to be the Bludgeon Brothers all day long. I will love this match to turn into a three-way, you know, triple
That'd
threat
match. That'd
be nice
match. To have it I as think a three-way.
Each of these six competitors deserve to be on SummerSlam.
Yep.
This is the second biggest pay-per-view of the year.
Yep.
I think that would be phenomenal. And if that's the case, I can see the Bar coming out on top on that one. Now, at this particular time of the taping here today, the Raw Tag Team titles are announced. Monday night, they did the whole thing with B Team against Matt and Bray and the Revivals, which I think that was their way of not adding them to the show. I still think they should have been on the show.
Right.
Another match for this card, for the Intercontinental Championship, Ziggler against Seth Rollins.
I think I'm going to have to go with that they're going to give it to Rollins, even though I'd like to go with Ziggler. I really think that they need to give Ziggler a strap and keep him strapped for a little while.
I 100% agree with you with that. They need to keep it on him. I would love to see this as a ladder match. I think Steph would be the guy, but I'm going to hold off. I'm going to go with Ziggler. I think they like what Ziggler and Drew is doing at this moment, and I really think they're the new age two dudes with attitudes.
Yep.
Shawn and Diesel. I think they're the new age. I think I'm going to go slight over. Ziggler's going to take this one.
Okay.
The Raw Women's title is going to be on the line. I know I keep stepping on that today. Alexa Bliss, Ronda Rousey.
They're definitely giving it to Rousey. I don't care for either one of them.
I
think Alexa Bliss is too egotistical in her own right, and she lives the lifestyle that she's her gimmick, and I think Rousey is too rough.
Yeah,
I think she's too much like a Brock Lesnar, and she's going to get somebody hurt.
I definitely think if you look back at a week or so ago when she main event with Alicia Fox, which Fox should have been on a main event a lot sooner than this.
Oh, yeah.
And came out to her own music instead of Bliss's music. That's a whole nother story. You can see how she was taking the flips and everything and the look that she was getting, like, wow, like this person still needs the training. Not knocking her, but when you're coming from one extreme type of area to another type of extreme,
it's hard to differentiate.
Yeah, they're not the same.
The softness that you have to use in wrestling compared to UFC or MMA.
Right. Like, you got to remember, UFC, they do a match once every couple of months.
Yeah.
And it's not, I book you, you have a fight this Sunday night, and then 2 months you're going to have another fight. No, you might have 6 months off before your next fight. These guys are wrestling 4 or 5 nights a week. So at that case, my thoughts, I think they're going to give it to Ronda. I don't think that she should deserve the title at this time.
I don't think she needs it yet.
I think she's going to take it, but I love to see her win the match on a DQ and not take the title. AJ Styles, Samoa Joe, the WWF title.
Excuse me. I have to say Samoa Joe.
Yes. I think Joe's going to win it. Joe's going to be the spectacular match. I think the two... Well, three matches are really going to be looked at, but the Intercontinental and the WWF title matches are going to be two title matches that people are going to want to see who's carrying the title over.
Right.
And because of that fact, that's why I think Ziggler might take the edge a little bit, and Samoa Joe's going to take it for sure. The other match people are going to talk about, but I don't think they're going to really care so much on the title aspect, Brock, Roman Reigns, Universal title, who's got it?
I don't care for Brock Lesnar, so it's Roman Reigns, whether they give it to him or not.
I think Roman Reigns...
I don't think they're going to give it to him, though.
I think they're going to. And I think the thing is, if they don't give it to Roman Reigns, that title means absolutely... It already means nothing. You know what I mean? Because you have somebody as a champion, and now they're starting to work in the storyline. Well, he don't want to be there, everything, because they're listening to what everybody's saying. But when it comes down to it, the title hasn't been on TV that much. He's going on... He'll be over 500 days by this Sunday. And he's been on TV maybe 13, 14 times. That's not enough time for a brand new title that's only been around for a couple of years now.
Right.
I think they're going to give it to Roman Reigns. It would not. I think if people gave it to Roman, they're going to be upset, but people are going to tune in. If they give it to Brock, they're not going to care nothing about that belt at all, and they're going to waste their money and time.
Right.
Those are our predictions. Let's see what happens at SummerSlam. I can't wait.
Right.
It's going to be phenomenal. This week here, ladies and gentlemen, we are talking about what series?
The Adrenaline series, folks.
You got to have adrenaline. I don't know. I don't even know why they named the series this, but they did.
And if you don't have adrenaline, drink some It Works energy drinks.
So
they give me adrenaline.
The good thing about this series here, this is when they were going... from the two tough packs and stuff like this. This series came out and it actually went a lot further in the series numbers that they expected. They always went up to 3 and 9,
yeah,
right?
They went really high.
And they didn't want to do that, but it was getting over so well. They turned this around and they went into, when they went to Mattel, they had to change the name, as that's where they got the battle pack from. And that's already up there.
Okay.
But this series is a very cool series because they put guys that were wrestling against each other, feuds, tag teams, and some of those odd figures, like, wow, this is pretty cool that they did that. Series 1, they kicked it off at RVD with Shawn Michaels, Brock Lesnar and Big Show, Tommy Dreamer and Jeff Hardy.
Ew.
You know, if you really think about it, it's phenomenal that Jeff Hardy and Tommy Dreamer is the rarer of the whole set, which it's kind of, you know, unexpected because you had Show with Lesnar and stuff, but that's how it is. And that's probably going in the ballpark about $200
right.
Unsigned. If that's signed, and it depends on how the autograph is by Jeff, meaning how he signs. If he signs just the drawing signature, if it has his name with it, if it has a picture with it, you're probably going to look at about $350 to $400 for that figure.
Right.
Series 2, the brother kicked in with Matt Hardy with Rey Mysterio. You had Johnny Saboni with Chavo Guerrero Jr., Tess with Stacy Keibler. That's a very popular series line as well, too. Now, we're not going to be able to read every single, you know, series off to you with every single name. We're going to just pinpoint this. You can get an official checklist on our website. Just go in there. If you go to Behind the Curtain with the collectibles, scroll on down, you're going to see checklists. And you can actually print them out yourself, too. And in coming weeks, we are going to have a picture checklist that you guys can also work with as well, too. It does take a lot of work. If anybody is ever interested in volunteering for the museum, just send us a message through the website, and somebody will get back to you right away. A two-pack that I liked was Eddie Guerrero and Chavo Guerrero Jr. That was Series 6. I think that was a very cool series. Also in that series, and we have them right here on the table right here, Rosie with the Hurricane. That series there was a really nice series that they put together. APA was in there, and Los Guerreros, you know, like I just said, with Eddie and Chavo. But what was cool with that series, though, is you had the hero gimmick of Rosie.
Right.
But it was the training version. They didn't make a training version anywhere else. And it was something that was very well over. Remember, during this time frame, the Hurricane was the only one with a gimmick and the only one that was getting it over on the screen. Nobody else had it. He played this character for 3.5 years, full force. Then he put a Samoan guy basically under the same gimmick, and he wore sweats and everything, and he got over with it.
Right.
That tells you how popular gimmicks are. And how well they are.
Right.
Is there anything popping out to you that you like and that really is eye-popping to you?
The other one that pops out to me, we actually have on the table here too, is the Adrenaline Series 31 with Chuck Palumbo and Michelle McCool. I really like Michelle McCool. She was definitely one of my top favorite women of all time. And she also is in this, where they're also in the series with Big Daddy V and Matt Stryker and the Highlanders, Rory and Robin. I also like Matt Stryker too. He's also a really cool guy.
He's a great guy. We had a production meeting and we are actually thinking who we want to bring on to the show. Either it's going to be here in the studio or when we take it on the road. That's another project that we're working on that we're going to let you guys know in soon. If you missed Off the Ropes this week, I don't know where you guys tune in, guys. All right, but we have something special coming next week. We're going to tell you guys about a special monthly show that we're going to do, so make sure you tune in for that.
Yep.
But Matt Stryker, he loves the business. He's got the mind for the business.
Oh, yeah.
This figure that's signed, though, for the museum, it's kind of odd where McCool and Chuck Palumbo signed it. It was like right on top of each other. But a lot of people didn't think they got along. They really did get along at that time. And, you know, Chuck's a great guy. We met him, you know, doing one of his shows.
Oh, yeah.
Another series that we have here, Series 32. This series was really cool. It had Jesse and Festus,
which is
Luke Gallows. That was a very well over team, another gimmick team itself. On the table, Santino Morales and Maria.
Yep.
Okay, that was a huge series, a huge team that was out there. And then you had Eminem. Miz and Morrison. Okay, and that team was just phenomenal. That's when, you know, a team that Miz came back
yep.
from not knowing how to wrestle, he got trained, came back and they put these two guys.
To being as great as he is.
Yeah.
Like, he's really come a long way, too.
And that's what these series have. You know what I mean? Like, you were talking about Viscera and Matt Stryker.
Yep.
A manager with a wrestler.
Yep.
A valet, McCool with Palumbo.
Yep.
Santino with Maria. The Festus. They put these things together, and it wasn't like the two packs that they had or the grunge matches that they had, you know, in the earlier series. These guys here was, all right, these are the ones I want to buy to put in the ring.
Right.
You know, in my action figures ring. Oh, these are the ones I want to get because I need to make sure they definitely have them.
Right.
A couple other things we're going to just skip through here. There was Kelly with Balls Mahoney, Series 30. That series also had Umaga in it with Triple H.
Mm-hmm.
The last series was Tyson Kidd and Natalya. We actually have that sign in our museum with D.H. Smith.
Yes,
Again, this has over 39 series altogether. It's a great series. Ted DiBiase with Cody Rhodes in 35.
They have the Basham brothers.
Yep,
Doug Basham and Danny.
Yep.
They have Cena, Funaki. They have Heyman.
Series 24,
Muhammad
London and Kendrick.
Hassan.
Yes. And that's the thing. If you can get Muhammad
There's
Hassan,
like
a two-pack.
There's anybody and everybody
yep.
in this.
If you
this
get that two-pack, that's very rare. Anything with Viscera in it, Uso.
Psychosis,
yep. Absolutely. Umaga is great. Another pack here on the table. Series 25 is Kane and MVP. Again, congrats, Kane. You're our man. Right here in front of us, Series 7, we have Chris Jericho and Christian. At that time when that came out, they really didn't know why they really made that series, that two-pack. They ended up having a great feud, and they kind of split off. That was phenomenal. That series also has Tess with Scott Steiner and Orton Batista, which you can check those sign on our site. And we also have 35, Kurt Hawkins and Zack Ryder. A great pack. These guys love them. If you ever get that, definitely get a sign. That's also with DiBiase and Rhodes, Evan Bourne and Rey Mysterio. So, if you want more information about this series, if you want to know what you should get, what you shouldn't get, in all honesty, this particular line,
anything.
I won't say anything is good to go. I don't see one figure on here, even if there's a repeat after so many series, that I will say, you know what, you don't need to get this. It's a great piece to display on the wall. It's a great piece to get signed, and it's a great piece if you want to get for somebody to open up. You can actually get a lot of these series pretty decently cheap still these days.
Yep.
So that's great. Each and every week, we're going to try to get to some questions now. But each and every week, we try to answer as many questions that you guys send in. You can send it to the official WrestleMuseum.com. You can send it to our Twitter account, Wrestling_Museum. Just drop the G. So what we're going to do is try to answer some of the best questions, our best answers for your questions, I should say. So let's see what we can get to this week and what we got going on.
All right. This question, I am not sure on the answer to, but it's definitely a question that came across that I had to put on the show.
Mm-hmm.
And it is it true WWE pays fans to cheer for Roman Reigns?
So this was a story that just recently broke too,
mm-hmm.
because Kevin Dunn, I believe it was, sold a bunch of his stocks, and they were saying that they were paying $100 to $200 and new signs, all this stuff. I don't think this is true.
Okay.
I think he just sold it to make some pocket money.
Okay.
The stocks are going phenomenal right now. And let's think about it. You don't matter if you love Roman or hate Roman, you're going to cheer for him or you're going to boo him.
Right.
So no matter if the crowd is behind him or not, you still get that reaction.
Right.
It's not like this. You have your main event guy getting crickets. It's what they call in
exactly.
the business, nothing. So I think this is totally false. WWE would never invest money that well into a character. They might give you little paper signs, but they're never going to do something that much.
Okay.
All right. Do you think that WWE will ever bring back an all-team Survivor Series show?
I don't know.
I don't think so. I would love for them to be an all-team Survivor Series show, pay-per-view. I don't think they'll do it, but it will get over so great, and I think so many people will like that.
Right. Didn't at one time WWE spell Brett with two T's?
True. That is true. They did it with two T's. Once they see that they were going to keep him on board with the Hart Foundation and they start breaking up, they dropped the second T. There was rumors that it used to cost too much to print the name on promotions, on newspaper ads, and it was too much to add the extra T on TV.
Well then.
I don't know how that worked back then, because I would just think you just hit and I don't think they charge like that.
Right.
That was the story that was going around. I haven't heard anything different. I think they just dropped it because it was just easier to drop it. Hmm. What's your thoughts on the Billy and Chuck tag team?
It's kind of an iffy one.
I personally love that tag team.
Yeah?
I think they played it to a T. The manager, Rico at that time, did a great job. They played it up like they were these loving guys. They were so into each other. They went all the way to the wedding time, and they're like, whoa, 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 whoa. Like, I thought this was just for show. You know, they had everybody believing it. They played the characters tremendously. I think hats off, that's how gimmicks should be. And I kind of like how they ended it because the storyline was getting kind of played out with them, mm-hmm. and they ended it great. I loved it. I wouldn't mind a two-pack of them, to be really mean.
Okay.
Your turn.
Is Paul Heyman really a good thing for TV? Yes.
Yes. And hats
absolutely
off.
Absolutely, yes.
What was that? I think a week or so ago, he did the interview with Renee Young with Brock Lesnar.
Oh, my God.
He
that was cried. Great.
He had the non-shaver. He is a
he
true
so
heel.
He looked so scared.
Yep.
To be in front of Brock Lesnar, like, it just, that was absolutely great.
Paul
like, he
Heyman
played that
is
to a T.
money, plain and simple.
Cool. Oh,
he
my
is
God.
Money, he is somebody.
The dude can talk, he
yeah.
can, oh, man.
And he has a backstage role now helping writing, so the shows should be getting a
yep,
lot better
that's
than
cool.
that. Should WWE make a Max Moon figure?
Yes.
I think it would be great. I love it. Let's do it up. Max
yes.
Moon, awesome. And if he shoots out his little things, even better. Of course, he'll probably charge you $6 more for that.
Did we see how Jerry the King showed respect to his son at an indie show? Yes, I did, actually.
Yes. Actually, we were going to talk about this at the
yeah.
end of this show. We're going to show a couple pictures right now. His first show back was the Sunday after he buried his son.
Yep.
And he wore a vest for him, as you can see. He had, prior to the show, his pants and stuff were draped over the ring. And on our website now, we have a picture of Brian and Jerry the King. And it's basically what our museum is all about, showing the respect, reliving, relearning. And just that image of him going through the curtain, well, backstage leaning to the curtain, shows everything that we stand for.
Mm-hmm.
And don't make it seem like I'm trying to say Jerry did our job, because it's not that. But what you have is, you have somebody, a worker in the business, that's very, very well over, that has more years in the business, wearing somebody else's gear to the ring to show respect. That is huge for any wrestler to do. Forget about the fact that it was father and son. That is huge. You don't do stuff like that.
Right.
You know, I mean, you have to have a certain number of respect of yourself for that worker. And without being in the business, it's hard to explain it, but you have to have the level on the wrestling level of a locker room to be able to pull something like that off, because you get bad repercussions. On the flip side, to see a father go out and do it for their son, and just to know the story that they had and everything that you heard, it's just, to me, it just shows the type of gentleman Jerry is.
Right.
It shows what Brian Christopher meant to the business. And we are going to be with him later in this month. If, mm-hmm. As far as I know, he's still booked for the show. And I'm hoping to bring some of that gear, because I would personally love to see it just face-to-face.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
That would be great.
My thoughts are still with everybody that passed away and their family.
Yep.
But that was so honorable. And you learn respect. There was respect there. You relive the passion of the business and what it is, and you relearn. And you relearn about, it doesn't matter what anybody says, there's always time to have respect. There's always time to remember, and there's always time to just make somebody smile.
Yep.
This isn't a cheap plug, but we have a Hall of Fame movement. This is what the Hall of Fame movement's all about. It's powered mostly with the Smile Up Challenge. Smile with your dumb up, spend more smiles than hate in the world. This is what it's about, because we want people to really know the world doesn't have to be so bad. And we ain't going to change how our taxes are paid. We ain't going to change that they put tolls up in places.
Right.
We can change the everyday life by a simple smile, by simply paying respects to somebody. Hey,
yep.
How you doing? Holding a door open. For him walking out with his son's stuff, that's a perfect example. You know, I'm so proud of you.
Right.
Should WWE, we're going to try to get a couple more questions. Should WWE ever have a feud with the Usos, one-on-one?
Like the Usos fighting against each other?
Yep.
Oh. I don't know.
I think
it would be interesting to see, but
I think tag teams having feuds with each other works good. I think Brett and Owen did it. The Hardy Boys did it. It gets over good. I think with the Usos, though, I would like to see them go against each other maybe in a Royal Rumble. You know what I mean? Tangle up. But to do an actual feud, I don't think will work good with them. I think if they do a match against each other,
yeah,
because they had an advance in a tournament or something.
Yeah, maybe a match.
But from day one, they were, I don't think so.
Yeah, maybe a match, but I don't think as an actual feud to go for a long period of time. They're twins.
Right.
Even though they're not twin, you know what I mean? They're twins, but you can tell them apart. They're twins. You can't have the same person fighting each other. It doesn't.
Right.
I think it would be bad for business. That's my 2 cents.
There we go.
Okay, so is the Bludgeon Brothers better now than they were a part of the Wyatts? And I top hat off to that, yes. I say that they are.
I think they are, but if they weren't a part of the Wyatts, this gimmick would not get over as well as it did. The Wyatt gimmick built them up to the Bludger level. They just took it to the next level. They really show what Bray was talking about, of how demented they were, and they were able to find peace with Bray. And now because they're not with Bray, they can do this demented stuff and hit go crazy.
Right.
Without the Wyatt gimmick, this would not be up here, my opinion. But I love the gimmick. I think they're 10 times better now. We're going to try to get one more question before we have to cut the show today, folks. What's our thoughts on Shannon Moore?
My personal thoughts on Shannon Moore is that he is not very humble.
I think Shannon Moore, I think the problem when it came to Shannon Moore is whatever he did with 3 Count when he was in WWE, all this kind of things. I think the problem with it was he was so good, but he was there with other people. And they were able to market the other people, like the Hardy Boys, like Shane Holmes with 3 Count, Ever Courageous. So I think he kind of got the crap end of the stick when it came to this stuff. If he came and shined by himself, I think it would be great. I would personally love to see him in 205 now. And you can grab his Ruthless Aggression figure. It is a phenomenal figure. I love that figure. He has a great signature. I kind of wish that we can get out more. And I think he kind of had that kind of grunge with people because of what you said. And
right.
I think it's just because how he was that odd person getting booked. And, I think he should be more booked than that. Anyway, get your questions into to Figures of Us each and every week. We're going to try answering for you guys. Next week here, we are going to talk about the items that you should get signed. And how we're going to do is how things work and everything. So that's what we're going to do for you guys. What you should get signed for, what level you are as a collector or a buyer. Thank you guys very much for tuning in to us this week. Get your questions in. Wrestling_museum. Drop the G at Twitter or at theofficialwrestlingmuseum.com. Next week on Off the Ropes, we're talking about the dead man himself, The Undertaker. Thank you guys very much for tuning in. And I know what I'm about to do. I'm going to go surf the officialwrestlingmuseum.com, baby.
I'm going to go drink some water.
Thank you guys. Have a great day.
Bye. I don't wanna grow up. Bye.